for an institution of this nature is not enough and can never be enough. Excellency, on behalf of the children of these homes, on behalf of the management committee, I want to thank you so much for that speech and the sincerity in it. And I know you mean every single word that you've said about the children of this country. And it is our hope that we can work with you and your administration in every capacity, in every community that we are, so that we can achieve whatever your vision is, which is a similar vision that I'm sure that every Guyanese will have of this country. So my dear brothers and sisters, it's really an honor to have this crowd here. I see so many people, and if I start recognizing, it will go on to the night. So I want to first thank my dear friend Amar. Amar, when he played last week at the Eid Fest, I mean, it was a resounding success, and we've had so many calls for more programs with Amar and his team. And I called him and asked him if he would do us the favor to come and serenade the children of the orphanages. And immediately he said yes. And I want to thank you, Amar, for that and for reaching out to the children. And this is what we want. Whatever we benefit, they must also have. And today, we stand and I want to say lastly about the orphanages, that the orphanages, like Dolly would have said, doesn't belong to anybody. It is the property of you, the people of this country, and therefore you have every right to question us. You have every right to ask for financial accountability. You have every right to ask for accountability as to the affairs of the children. That's what we're here for. That's what we're doing. And we pray and hope that we will have more and more of persons coming forward to offer us help, that we can do more for these children of these institutions. So I want to, as I thank Amar, I want to thank His Excellency the President for being here this afternoon. I did tell him that, you know, circling and circling, he should have arranged that they could have dropped him right here, you know, and we would have loved to catch him out there and we'd be informed in time. But that is the care of a man who has grown to be friends, our friends, and we, you know, the kind of respect that we have for the president of this country. And I hope and pray that, and I'm sure the kind of respect that comes back to the presidency of this country is one that we are very grateful that is happening, you know, and he brings a lot of respect to that position, and we are very happy that that is happening. So my dear brothers and sisters, I want to thank you very much on behalf of the children and on behalf of the board of the Shaheed Boys and Girls Orphanages, and do follow us in whatever we're doing. At programs at the Anak African Islamic Complex, these children will always be there. And they will always follow us wherever we are, whenever we do activities. And I want to say to you, like I said at Anak African a month or so ago, we will take your challenge, Excellency, and we will set ourselves a goal for the 50th anniversary of the independence of this beautiful nation, and we'll set ourselves a goal that we and our children can achieve, and that when 26th of May 2016 is here, we can say that the Shaheed Orphanages have achieved a milestone in the 50th year of the independence of this country. I want to take the opportunity here also from the Anak African Islamic Complex and the Ghana United States Islamic Anjuman to thank His Excellency, and also to let him know that we are receiving so much support from your government ministers and other officials, especially, I mean, our sister Amna has been there. I mean, we can call on her any hour of the night, I know that. And she has always been very responsive, as the other ministers have been going through meeting with them and getting them to know what we're doing and how we can help. So we want to thank him for making that way for us so that we can properly represent the Muslims of this country. Thank you again, and hope to see you. Next big event is at Arica Arena on the 14th to the 17th of August, when we welcome hundreds of people coming from overseas, and I hope the plane don't turn back then. So we're going to welcome them at this in this country through the Arica Arena Islamic Complex, the Ghana United Saudi Islamic Anjuman, the Ministry of Tourism, Fly Jamaica Inc., the Ghana Telephone and Telegraph Company, Shami Mehfil 2, the International Qasida Competition, and the International Qasida Mehfil, August 14th to the 17th. So you'll hear more about that, and you'll see us there at the Arica Arena Islamic Complex. So thank you very much.
Catherine Islamic Complex, and also the Secretary of the Orphanage Board. While we're going to ask our friends from Mendo's Voices to play some music as we wrap things up, I'm going to just invite our children of the orphanages to come in front here so we can have a group picture with His Excellency the President. So if I can ask the children coming forward, please, from the back, and I can ask Amar in the meantime to just go ahead and play some music for us.